Hello, and welcome to the People's Mental Stimulus Update. Well, today we're going to take a dive off of a different board. Basically meaning that I'm not going to worry about talking about Mitch McConnell or Chuck Schumer or the Democrats or Republicans. I'm going to talk about the Trumplicans. Those that are so in love with Donald Trump that they can't get his dick out their ass. I'm sure you guys have all seen these people out there that have the Trump 2020, Trump 2024 flag still flying, still supporting him, still wanting him to be president, saying he's going to come back in office. Well, today, I'm going to give you a few clips of some of these morons. That's right, they're morons because Donald Trump's not coming back because the 14th Amendment says that anyone who's practiced in an insurrection or any other treasonous activities against the United States cannot hold office after that point. Well, as you notice, Trump has basically committed an insurrection with Josh Hawley, Ted Cruz, and a few others. But we're not going to go off on them. We're just going to go show you some of the new Trumplican crap out there that they're still jumping up and trying to, you know, give Trump a happy ending, even though he's the biggest loser on the planet because he's a child sex offender, as well as other things which I'll cover in other topics. So if you stick with me, I have a few videos for you to watch. They're short clips, about a minute long each at best. Some are shorter. And you guys are all more than welcome to comment on everything I put on here. I have no problem with that. And all the request is, if you like what you see, please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel and let me know that what you would like to see. And if I can find it, I will give it to you. Until then, you guys have a wonderful evening. Bye.
Our hat here, because he will be running again in 2024, and he will fucking win.
President Trump signed the original Constitution, the 1770.
And you just see the disrespect for America now, just in a matter of few months, because Joe Biden is president. Is there now? Because Joe Biden is president, we're no longer respected on a world stage like we were when President Trump was in office and president.
That's crazy talk.
As world leaders were snickering at the President of the United States.
The demonstrators are opposed to Mr. Trump's very presence in Britain.
World leaders caught on camera laughing about President Trump.
Several world leaders mocking President Trump.
They're laughing at him.
We're going to work as hard as we can to stop the Democrats' agenda because their agenda is radically changing our country as right before our eyes.
Fucking Biden. Not like he hasn't killed enough jobs. He's going to kill a bunch more. Now he wants to raise the corporate tax from 21% to 28%. That's why businesses left before, is because the corporate tax was so high. That's why so many of them were coming back under Trump, because he lowered it down to 21. It ought to actually, if Biden had a brain anywhere, he would lower it down to like 18% for corporate taxes. That would bring so many businesses back to the United States, create so many jobs, have so many more taxpayers, and you would get your tax revenue. That's what Trump was doing. But the Democrats and Biden are too stupid to realize that. Ooh, the mean old corporate guys, the mean old rich people, they're the bad guys. No, they're not. They're the employers. They're the ones that keep this country going. Without the corporates, we're fucked.
And Laura Trump, she was caught funneling money directly from a charity to Donald Trump. And from whom did she steal? She stole money from a shelter for abused puppies. Who would do that? Fucking puppies. But hey, she's right at home here.
The president misused his own charitable foundation.
Trump, Melania, Ivanka, Donnie Jr., and Eric are legally forbidden from ever working with charities after they defrauded millions from a charity that helped kids with cancer. Kids with cancer and now puppies? What's next? I don't even want to know.
14th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution is clear. No American who is engaged in insurrection or rebellion is allowed to hold office. While 7 Republican senators voted to overturn the 2020 election, Ted Cruz and Josh Hawley share the most blame for firing up the violent mob of Trump supporters that attacked the U.S. Capitol and killed 5 people.
We will not go quietly into the night. there were big problems with this election, there were major election integrity issues, there needs to be an investigation, there need to be changes to the law.
The same terrorists who Josh Hawley greeted at the Capitol with a raised fist broke into the People's House with the intent to kidnap and even murder elected officials.
Death is the only remedy for what's in that building.
Even after the Capitol was breached and blood had been spilled, Ted Cruz and Josh Hawley continued undeterred to lie about the election.
Now, good evening, I'm Erin Burnett. Out front tonight, an accused Capitol rioter flips. CNN now learning that one of the people charged after storming the U.S. Capitol has agreed to help the Justice Department in its case against the Proud Boys leadership. It's a significant move, and according to an attorney familiar with the case, it could lead, ready for this, to more severe charges against those allegedly involved in the insurrection. Well, that comes with great implication, right? For anybody who could possibly be blamed for the insurrection? Okay, this is where the former Republican House Speaker John Boehner enters, because he is squarely placing the blame on Trump for the deadly attack on the U.S. Capitol. According to excerpts from his new book obtained by the New York Times, Boehner writes, he never minces words, Trump incited that bloody insurrection for nothing more than selfish reasons, perpetuated by the BS he'd been shoveling since he lost a fair election the previous November. Like I said, Boehner says it like it is. He doesn't mince words. It's a stunning charge, though.
Language is downright totalitarian. Ready? We need to know we haven't lost you to the radical left. If you uncheck this box, we will have to tell Trump you're a defector and sided with the Dems. Check this box and we can win back the House and get Trump to run in 2024. If you uncheck the box, they're personally going to tell Donald Trump you're a defector. Literally the message here. If you keep the box checked, we're going to just keep scraping your bank account every month. Remember, if you get to the point where you're reading these boxes, you have already committed to giving money to the Republican Party. But instead of thanking you, the NRCC says they will tell dear leader personally you were a traitor.
I got this feeling inside my bones. You in the club, just to party, I'm there, I get paid a fee. Let's ride.